Alright guys, so today I am going to be taking a look at the High Grade Gundam Caliborn from Wish from Mercury. There are a total of 6 runners that makes up a Gundam Caliborn, obviously with the beam effect parts, a medium sized sticker sheet that is for the color correction, and an action base as well. Although the construction was fairly simple, but it is definitely going to leave you a great impression upon completing it. I don't even think the amount of parts or the number of runners is going to make the difference. I think it's just the matter of engineering that went behind all of the Wish from Mercury kits, which is why it was a widely praised of how good they are, and by no means this is definitely not an overstatement at all. Despite the fact that Caliborn is somewhat of a mono-colored kit with a bit of a red in the torso and feet area, there's still a lot of good panel lining opportunities, so you can definitely make this kit a little bit more vibrant in a sense. But I would have to say some of those lines are a little bit too shallow, so if you guys are trying to ink it in, it's not gonna leave you with a great look into it, so I think cleaning a factor is going to be a problem. So if you guys do have some extra time, or if you want to put in some extra touch into this kit, I will definitely advise probably using a scribing tool and run it alongside those really shallow areas. And when you do apply those ink into those scribe area, they are gonna look a little bit more presentable, and then giving you that extra depth that you will probably see from other areas as well. So that is definitely something I would suggest to do. The numb marks are surprisingly easy to clean up as well, so you wouldn't really have to worry about leaving behind those nasty marks as well. The antenna and then the torso shell unit does come in the gray clear piece, and then the rainbow version, or aka the Permit Score A for your choice. The other shell unit areas would need to rely on the black sticker sheet, or you want to go with the Permit Score A as well, you can do that as well. But I think before I'm even going to be touching the stickers or whatsoever, I'm going to try to find a way to see if I can make it glow using the fluorescent color. So I'll definitely have to see what I can do with that. And lastly, for you guys' information, when I was trying to cut down the face mask, please do be careful because mine did actually snap in half in the process. So I think that was probably the only flimsy part in throughout the process. But other than that, you just have to, if that does happen to you guys can just kind of glue it with those Tamiya cement glue, and you guys should be pretty much good to go. But other than that, let's kind of move over to the articulation. Alright, starting with the head articulation, the head can move up and down, rotate 360, no problem. The arms, you can swing it forward like this to get a better angle, and you can raise it all the way up, so these are separate, so yeah. The arms is going to be able to bend as follows, and then going to be followed by a single joint bent only. And the hands is going to be on a ball joint, so you can wiggle, rotate without any problem. The waist, you can swing it forward like this, so that's actually a lot of ab crunch. Side to side is pretty decent as well. Moving down to the waist section, the front skirt can move up like this. Side skirt, you can kind of swing up on both ends as well. Back skirt, there's no movement, but you do have this right here that you can add in the gun bits. The legs, you can actually give it a full split like this, and then you can swing it all the way out like this. But backwise, you are going to be hindered by the back skirt, unfortunately, no movement at all. In terms of the bend, is actually pretty good, so you can kind of do something like this, so that's actually a lot. So if you do want to do like a kneeling pose, I think it's actually quite possible as well, so that's good. Moving out to the feet guard, this is going to be on a ball joint, so you can actually move it up and down and rotate any direction you want. And the feet itself, you can bend all the way down like this. And the back section, you can actually rotate in any direction you want as well. And there's actually a high mobility mode as well, so what you want to do is actually put the front of the feet all the way down, and then this gray section, you kind of fold, just flip it all the way down like this, so you can kind of have it as really, I think what they're trying to have this as is, I think it's just really flush, so when you are flying high mobility mode, this is you're not really blocked by any wind current or any of that, so you have that. Moving to the backpack, you do have these two. I don't even know what you want to call these. They're kind of thrusters. They're more, you can hold your gambit as well. But anyways, they are in a ball joint, so they can't rotate in any direction you want, but they are quite loose and they don't really give you the most flexibility of range, so you do have that. This piece right there, this actually fold down so you can actually insert the gambits and then just clamp back up like this. Starting up the accessory, we obviously do have the blue beam effect part that just insert like this, and you can just hold it on to the hands without any problem. Pretty tight fit, so you wouldn't have to worry about falling apart at all. Up next, we have the variable pot rifle. So this thing obviously looks like a broom, you know, y'all already know this, but yeah, this thing is actually just back heavy. Like this section right here, even though it's composed of not too many parts together, but dude, this is making, like, this is actually weight heavy right here. In front of this is just really just light, if you want to call it that. But great details, obviously. So I did not actually apply the sticker yet. I think I actually will. I don't really want to paint this section myself. I don't think it's gonna look as clean as the sticker just being all cut up for me, so we'll have that. But great movement as well, so you can actually give it a lot of just any range you want, but I think ideally you want to keep it like this for just flying, and then for kind of compact mode you just fold it like this, so you have that. Great details in here as well, right? Obviously. And this whole section does actually extend. If you ever wanted to have a longer broomstick, you have that as well. So the handle, this is going to be the main handle right here, so you can actually fold it all the way down. Let's not actually do that though. And then you have the secondary handle right there, and then you have this little piece right here. So this piece actually would slap onto this hole right there, so this is ideally for I guess for the holding position, because obviously the rifle is extremely heavy, so Caliburn itself, the kit itself, just could not handle it. So what you will do now, you will actually take this and then you will peg it into this polycap right here, or this ball joint, bam, and then you can just have it, let's see if we can get in, get this in. So you just kind of reposition this, and then it will fit in nicely as well. So yeah, that is essentially how it's gonna look like, and it's not too terrible having kind of like a connection piece right there. Obviously it's not going to be as enemy as accurate where it's really holding the rifle without any connection, but you guys can see it does kind of suffer from some back heavy because of this portion right here. So yeah, up next, so we have the shield, or the escutcheon, if that is how you pronounce it. So we have seen this 3 times already from the Aerials rebuild, so this is just the white variant of it. So let's actually get this attached onto the arms right here. So we have a hard point right here that pegs into here fairly nicely as well, so it does looks pretty clean. But in the anime, Caliburn does not actually receive the gambits until Aerials reborn or rebuild was destroyed, and then it inherited those shield bits. So yeah, we have these as well, but let me actually do get them connected onto the hardpoint and the Gundam itself as well. Alright, so I have equipped all of the gambits onto Caliburn itself, so it overall looks a little bit better now. We all expected when we saw those hardpoints, but I think now it looks a little bit complete, if you will. We have kind of everything that is on the unit, so it kind of gives me like a Victory 2-esque feel with these two, especially with these two on this area. So I mean, overall it doesn't look that bad. I think it's just the fact that this whole kit looks pretty bland. There's not a whole lot of color going on, so as you add in extra parts onto this kit, it definitely fills in that void in a way. So yeah, it's definitely not that bad. So let's actually get on to the comparison as well. Moving to the size comparison, we have pretty much every single unit that was piloted by Celetta. So yeah, I mean, all of them are pretty much identical in terms of height. I think overall for me personally, I like the rebuild a little bit better, because probably the head, I like the head from the rebuild and probably the aesthetics a little bit more than, let's say, the base areas. I'm not really the biggest fan of that. And then for the Caliborn, I think it's a little bit too bland for me. I think if there's much a little bit more color built into it, I think I'll probably enjoy it better. But for me, I think Rebuild is gonna be my favorite of the three. Up next, we have Celetta with her last unit that she ever piloted. So Celetta is actually a bit taller than Caliborn, so that's actually a bit surprising right there. Here we are with the entry gray Elstrek Gundam. So Caliborn is actually a bit taller than this one, so Elstrek is definitely is it actually shorter. I definitely gotta look at how tall they actually are, but you have that. Lastly, we have it with the Rising Freedom as well. So I have not built the Mighty Strike Freedom yet, so we're using this one. So again, Caliborn is a tiny bit taller against the Rising Freedom as well. And then for a added bonus, I am going to be comparing this against the Mobuzu Ensemble Caliborn as well. So you guys can see these are actually just really short. I think they are roughly about 4 to 5 inches tall, and it roughly about the height of the near the knee area. So that's gonna give you guys a good indication about how short they are. Like many of the Worship of Mercury kit, Gundam Caliborn is another fantastic build, despite the fact that there are only 6 runners that went into the overall process. Great details all around, and capture closely to how it is from the actual enemy itself. The C-joint connection from the legs area and the gun bit feeling a little bit loose from the backpack section don't really take away much from the kit. I feel that the overall positive factor still outweighs the minor issues from the kit itself. But other than that, that is going to be pretty much it in terms of the Gundam Caliborn review, and I'll be catching you guys all on the next one.